Saudi Arabia is mostly known as an oil-rich, Middle Eastern state, but with the crowning of King Solomon, winds of change have transformed the socio-economic landscape of the Saudi kingdom. The Kingdom of Saudi Arabia was founded in 1932 by King Abdulaziz. Since then, every king on the Saudi throne has been a direct son of Abdulaziz. The current reigning king of Saudi Arabia, King Salman bin Abdulaziz, is the last king in the long line of the sons of King Abdulaziz. After King Salman, his son, Prince Muhammad bin Salman, will be king. This transition will mark a great change in Saudi Arabia, as the line of kings will move down to a new generation of princes who want to see Saudi Arabia as inclusive, sustainable, and tech-savvy as the Western countries like the US. Muhammad bin Salman is the face of this socio-economic revolution that's transforming Saudi Arabia. For the major part of the previous century, Saudi Arabia reaped the benefits of oil exports. While the revenue from exporting oil made Saudi Arabia one of the most prosperous countries in the world, it had the drawback of making the country dependent on oil and oil alone. With fast depleting oil reserves, Saudi Arabia desperately needed to develop and restructure its economy so that it could support the country and its lavish lifestyle without being completely dependent on oil exports. In this bid to diversify the Saudi economy, the Crown Prince has decided to open up the Saudi economy by introducing far-reaching reforms in every sector of the economy and Saudi society. One development the Crown Prince has been working on is the creation of a completely new, futuristic city along the Red Sea coast called NEOM. NEOM is the brainchild of Muhammad bin Salman and is a vision of what the future could be for Saudi Arabia. With NEOM, Saudi Arabia attempts to do something that's never been done before. NEOM represents a completely different way of looking at some of the most basic problems that we face today. NEOM is driven by the ancient Greek prefix neo, which means new, and the last letter M has been taken from the Arabic word for future, which is mustaqbil. So together, NEOM means new future. At the heart of NEOM will be artificial intelligence, which will act as the central nervous system of the city, connecting everything together. This means that NEOM will have less humans and more robots to maintain the city. In fact, this is how the city's been envisioned. Robots are likely to form the working class, whereas humans will be free of economic constraints that usually keep them away from creative pursuits in life. But before we see what facilities NEOM will offer to humans living there, let's first look at the location and geography of NEOM. The city will be situated on the northwestern coast of Saudi Arabia, at the northern end of the Red Sea, along the Gulf of Aqaba. This gives strategic importance to NEOM, as almost 48% of the global population lives within a 4-hour commute from the city, making it extremely accessible. The total area of the city is going to be around 26,500 square miles, which makes it over 33 times as big as New York City. Its topography includes over 400 kilometers of coastline, coral reefs, mountains, and flatlands that will soon see skyscrapers, technology parks, and other facilities that even the most advanced cities in the world today don't have. The coolest and most memorable aspect of the city is that it will be built in a linear line, which is unlike any other city in the world. Saudi Arabia has initially set aside around $500 billion for the city, with the first phase of the city set to be completed between 2025 and 2030. Muhammad bin Salman unveiled the plan to create NEOM in the Vision 2030 Expo that was held in 2017. That year, Saudi Arabia hired McKinsey & Company, Boston Consulting, and Oliver Wyman, three of the world's leading consultancy firms, to guide them on how to create the perfect city for the future. These three consulting firms have laid out the plan to make NEOM a marvel of human endeavor. But creating such a grand vision of the future requires solving the problems that we face today. The first problem that the team behind NEOM encountered was the lack of water. Most of the landmass of Saudi Arabia is desert, and the climate's extremely arid and hot. Even the coastal areas of Saudi Arabia don't receive as much rainfall as other similar areas. This creates two problems. Firstly, water is a very scarce resource, and you can't build a sustainable, futuristic city without enough water. Secondly, the average temperature in Saudi Arabia is far too high, particularly for tourists who aren't climatized to the Saudi environment. So, how is NEOM going to solve these two problems? Well, according to the Wall Street Journal, NEOM is going to use cloud seeding technology to create artificial clouds for more rainfall. It's expected that the increased rainfall will turn the arid and dry land green, water reservoirs and dams will allow not only storage, but also generation of hydroelectricity to power the city. Rainfall is also expected to drop the temperatures of the region where NEOM is situated down by at least 10 degrees Celsius, making it cooler than any of the surrounding cities. The next obvious problem is, how will NEOM be governed? Even Mohammed bin Salman has stated that the laws applicable in Saudi Arabia need to be updated. But a city such as NEOM, which is based on artificial intelligence, inclusiveness, and sustainability, needs its own laws to function. Even countries like the USA don't have laws that are compatible with AI. For instance, a completely smart city governed by AI will use CCTV footage to identify and punish criminal behavior. This is not something that the masses are ready for yet. Recently, AI robot dogs patrolled the streets of New York, and they had to be taken back because the people simply didn't want to see robot dogs policing them around, which, to be honest, is perfectly understandable. If New York isn't ready for AI policing, then how could Saudi Arabia be? Well, this is why Mohammed bin Salman has decided that NEOM will have its own laws and administrative setup that will be independent of the Saudi government. NEOM will thus be fully autonomous and independent, with its own set of laws that will be crafted around the technologies used in the city. Of course, with human oversight. After all, we don't want AI to become sentient and take over the world. If you've made it this far into the video, then you must be wondering, what exactly will NEOM offer? So far, we've only talked about how grand it will be and where it will be located. So let's look at what NEOM will have to offer to its inhabitants. Firstly, it must be remembered that NEOM is not going to be for everyone. You can visit as a tourist, but in order to live there, you must prove that you can add value to the ecosystem of the city, which is why the city will welcome entrepreneurs from all over the world. There's a story that whenever Alexander the Great conquered a city, he used to take their philosophers and healers with him to learn from them. This way, he was able to learn from their wisdom and make decisions that benefited everyone. Well, NEOM takes a similar approach by attracting the best people from all over the globe to contribute to the entrepreneurial ecosystem. Another cool feature of NEOM will be its artificial moon. Everyone loves gazing up at the moon. It not only sets the mood for romance, but is also mesmerizing to watch. But the problem with full moons is that they only happen once a month. In NEOM, you won't have to wait that long, because according to the information published by the Wall Street Journal, NEOM is going to have its own holographic moon that will illuminate the city at night. If they can manage to create a replica of the moon, then it will certainly not be difficult to create a holographic alien invasion as well. This is bound to get the conspiracy community excited. Some may say that it will be a waste of resources to use holographic technology to create a fake moon when you already have a real moon, which is kinda true. But NEOM won't be using holograms for the moon alone. They plan to use holograms in schools and educational institutes to project the teachers into the classrooms to provide a unique learning experience. The past year has shown us that it is possible to conduct classes in virtual spaces. NEOM will take it one step further by using holographic projection to add more reality to virtual classes. This will allow NEOM to recruit top teachers from all over the world without them having to travel physically to NEOM to teach. This idea may not have been entirely original, as Jedi Council meetings already use holograms. Jedis have always used holograms to attend meetings and deliver messages. This surely means NEOM is going to have robots like C-3PO and R2-D2? Maybe not. If your mind isn't already blown, NEOM is also proposing to have its very own Jurassic Park with robotic dinosaurs. Let's hope these dinosaurs don't have artificial intelligence, otherwise the plot for Jurassic Park may be about to become very real. Robots are expected to actually outnumber humans in NEOM. This is one of the key features of the city. There will be robotic maids, waiters, baristas, and even robotic cage fights. Remember Real Steel, anyone? This is not just a proposed plan. Saudi Arabia is actively trying to turn this into reality. In the last year, the kingdom has introduced AI-based sanitizing and water dispensing robots in the two holy mosques. If the kingdom is introducing AI-based robots in areas that are considered holy, what they have in store for NEOM can only make us wonder. Mohammed bin Salman seems to be a big fan of sci-fi movies because his vision of NEOM seems to include every idea any sci-fi movie has ever pitched. He's big on tech and has high hopes for NEOM to have flying cars to help people commute. Concept taxi choppers were also revealed in the Vision 2030 Expo. Do you really think NEOM will have flying cars by 2030? Leave a comment, let us know what you think. Anyway, back to the video. NEOM will also have cars, but expects them to be fully electric. Mohammed bin Salman is a big fan of Elon Musk, and it won't be a surprise if we see Tesla everywhere in NEOM. Saudi Arabia, after all, has got a considerable stake invested in Tesla. NEOM is also set to become the center for genetic research. Saudi Arabia has plans to introduce gene-based medical diagnosis. People entering NEOM will have the option of creating a digital twin, where their genetic code will be used to diagnose and treat medical conditions. Gene-based medical diagnosis is in its nascent state, and it's expected that with NEOM it will get the funding it requires to scale up. Apart from this, there's a plan to cover the coastline with glow-in-the-dark sand for a Pandora-type aesthetic feeling. This is all we know so far from published and leaked material. In reality, the work on the ground is happening fast. The NEOM airport is ready and operational. Extreme sporting events regularly take place to promote the city, but there is little to see for now. It's not easy to build a city from scratch, and even more difficult to build one that aims to bring every sci-fi movie plot to life. It'll be interesting to see how NEOM takes shape in the coming years. For now, I guess we'll just have to sit back and wait for this awesome city to be completed. Are you excited about NEOM? Do you think you'll visit once the city's built? Let us know what you think in the comments section below. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on the bell icon to stay updated whenever we release a new video. Other than that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.